r/antiwork. Green cat says, mission impossible. Included photo. El Hardin says, back in 2016 I bought my home for $145,000. I made around 40k/year gross. After that the market went crazy. My house has just been valued at $350,000. My pay is 50k/year gross. I have been lucky to buy my house at the lowest point of the market. Right now the houses are straight up and up, and, speaking for the Dutch area, it's gonna go way more crazy, since we need about a 120,000 houses a year to fulfill the need and we are only building 50,000 to 70,000. So the market is going to overflow, and it's only the beginning. Stankwizzy says, agreed. But my home in 1997 for $104k on a $50k/year gross income. Same house is now worth $300+k and my income is only $100/e now. I could not afford the mortgage on my home if I bought it today. Mra certainly says, I don't want to be a harbinger of doom and gloom. But the worst isn't here yet. In 10 to 20 years, your taxes alone will be unaffordable. For some, that could be even now. I have friends in New Jersey and Brooklyn who bought homes many years ago, when property prices were reasonable, and they literally have sold them, because the values have exploded. Bought for sub-$100k, now worth nearly a $1 million. You'd think that's great, until you hear their tax bill. Many of them are close to retirement, going on to fixed incomes with higher healthcare costs as they age, and that tax number is not only astronomically high, it's constantly increasing. 1 month of taxes in northern NJ for a tiny suburban Clotten pre-war home is around a year's worth in rural PA for a 2 to 5 acre plot and modest modern home. It didn't used to be like this. So alright, let's say they sell, and get a cool $1 million in their hands. And now they have no place to live, where they grew up, where they have family and friends. And other property values are, yup, just as overpriced. These are people who did everything right. They worked long and hard, they saved, they didn't live lavishly. And now they have to move out to rural areas in other states, just because they can't afford the mere taxes on their property. We let our people down. Tacap News says, if they would just stop eating avocado toast, drinking lats, and cancel their Netflix subscriptions, they'd be able to afford a house in no time. r/antiwork. Cannabis Cabalt says, denied promotion, promoted employees won't stop asking me questions. I work at a small company, 60-ish people, and I'm on a team of project managers with one boss overseeing us. Usually we have a second boss who is a senior project manager, but that role is a revolving door, so my boss, a senior director, takes over the SPM job when it's empty. Eventually she gets fed up of doing the work, as she is busy with her actual job, and they hire a new SPM. They announced this time they'd be opening up the role to all PMS. There are 5 of us, and only 1 PM team in the entire company. I have 3 years of experience at this job and everyone else has less than 2. I also have the most amount of projects at any given time and am often given the more challenging projects as I can do them efficiently, saving hours often. Despite this, I didn't want to assume I would get the role due to seniority, so I prepared for the internal interview, and came up with several ideas of what I would do in the role. They asked for this. Well, I didn't get the job, they tell me casually, after chatting about my recent holiday I took, and then mentioned they hired 2 SPMs due to increased interest. I asked why and what I can improve on, and they said you are not consistent across each project and we need perfection for this role. They said the SPM cannot mess up, and needs to be perfect and am not perfect, exact wording. I'm upset but hold it in, until after the call is over. contemplating life cause this company is so small there's nowhere else to progress upwards. Next day one of the PMS quits, so we have two SPMS and two PMS, me and one girl who is newer to the job. They announce the SPMS formally, and mention they'll be taking on the hard projects, but having a lower volume of projects. At this time I find out from my PM coworker that she's super busy, and has 7 projects. We are friends so I'm not trying to downplay her stress, but it made me evaluate and damn I have 14 active projects and we are supposed to have 6 at any given time, indicating both me and other PM are overworked. Friday, a new rush project comes up, and my boss wants me to take it so for the first time ever I say no to the project, because I'm super busy with 14 projects and this rush one would be the same week that 4 other projects are fielding. I also had to take on projects from the PM who left, increasing my workload further. My boss messages us all begging someone to take the rush challenging project and the seniors are gasp silent. Eventually she messages all my projects to rearrange other timelines, so I'll have some time to squeeze this project in, and it lands in my lap. I'm rushing to set up the project meanwhile one of the new seniors is in my team's DMs asking me QS about a challenge she has on a project. A Q that she would have known if she had more experience. But I thought the seniors were the perfect know-it-alls. Then the company has the gall to ask me to leverage a family connection to help out with a project challenge because it would make the clients happy. Obviously I decline. My mom pointed out that they constantly give me projects that have challenges before it even starts, so how could one have a perfect project or consistency across all if they're all uniquely flawed before it even gets into my hands? I have the strong desire to quit and leave them high and dry during a busy time, so they have to reallocate my 14 projects across one newer PM and two SPMS, but I need to continue making money. I'm applying elsewhere, but for the first time ever I hate my job and the people I work with, including the SPMS. It's not their fault they were better and got picked, but I don't have a desire to be friendly anymore as a result of my boss's handling of the situation. I have one friend outside of work, the newer PM from this company, and she was so shocked when I told her all this stuff that went down. This company is so stupid, they say things like when everyone else zigs we zag, everyone else is hiring, so we stopped, everyone else is leaning into AI so we stopped, and then they wonder why the company is constantly not doing well. Maybe these successful companies know what they're doing, and we could emulate some of their behaviors. Anyways, writing this Sunday night as I finished updating my resume and LinkedIn. Here's to another busy week of hating my coalition or feeling says. You already have plenty of leverage. You just aren't applying it and sticking up for yourself. You see how you just communicated to us that you're unhappy, you have more experience than these seniors, and you're being worked harder while being paid less? Express that to your boss and let him know you're not happy with being passed on while 2 more SPMs were hired. If you can't get the promotion, fine, but you need a bump in pay. You don't get fired for leveraging / leveling with your superior in a respectful way when you're, in fact, very needed. They'll find out how to get you some extra money, because it's cheaper than paying to retrain someone else, while paying out overtime to whoever remains staffed while you're gone. Melancholy Liquor Fiend says. You bide your time, and give them only the bare minimum to keep the job, while you find another. WLFWRTR says. When SPM asks a question, respond, I'm sorry, as a PM I'm not qualified to answer that question. I would hate to give you an imperfect answer. Friendly Staff 1 says. Give them the bare minimum, and look for new jobs. Same situation for me, someone was hired under me who makes more than me, my raise to correct this was approved, but then boss left who needed to finalize all this left, and we got a temporary replacement who refused to change any salaries who is now permanent, and says there is no longer any budget. So someone who makes less than I do, is reporting to me, and wanting me to make all the decisions, and approve their work. JXX37 says. Why are you doing so much more than others? Work less. Say no when busy. See if expressing less emotions in interactions with your colleague or talking less, not smiling or nod along when others speak results in you being taken more seriously. Def01 says, learn to say no, push responsibility to those that have the authority. Responsibility without authority is a scapegoat. Ginger1T says, you're doing more projects than anyone else. You've made yourself indispensable at your current level. Concur with the other posters. Time to start looking elsewhere. TinyBasket9063 says, I think you could totally get away with giving 2 weeks notice and watch them scramble to find a way to keep you. There are unique situations where an employer can't afford to call your bluff, and this is one of them. That said, if they accept your notice, do not care one bit about tidying up loose ends. Just spend as much time possible applying to other jobs. I really don't think you will be out of work for more than a couple days before they are clamoring to get you back. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.